lift our hands and appreciate God for that testimony. Wave those hands to Him if you are grateful. Listen, Thanksgiving precedes a testimony. Can we say thank you, Jesus? Oh, we bless you, Lord Jesus.
See what the Lord has done. See what the Lord has done.
What we waited for
has come to pass. See what.
And guess what? We have been waiting and fasting. Lift your voice, say, see what the Lord. Oh, come on, if you've been waiting and fasting in these 21 days, the prayer challenge. What we're waiting for,
what we're waiting for
has come to pass.
Come to pass.
Oh, see.
See what the Lord.
I need somebody to declare it by faith. Oh, see what the Lord. Job. You've not gotten it yet, but thank you for that job. You've not gotten that healing.
Praise the Lord. I am more than a conqueror. Shall we rise to our feet and let's lift up our voices while welcoming the presence of the Holy Spirit this beautiful Sunday morning. Someone that is here to encounter God this morning, lift up your voice and begin to welcome God's presence. Lebno, Zikota, Rebunta, Riachreptos, Cantulta, Pele, and Dedo, Robozunda, Cre, Jeketo, Nipando, Liang, Neptos, Cantuta. Lord, we are before you this morning again. We are here to worship. We are here to bow. We are here to honor you. We are here to magnify you. We are here to partner with you. We are here again for your touch this morning. Lord, Mary Karuta Nianglebdo, take control of this service from the beginning to the end. Let it be my own encounter. Somebody is praying. Let this service be your own encounter. Lord, send your word again. Zeluyanguram Nagduskanto 3. Send us the rain of your word again. Let this morning be a life transforming encounter for me. Lekota Boranza Zizite Pre. Lek Noctos Kentota Imbrang Nuskat. Lay your expectations bare before the Lord this morning. Zezuzu entente ribnagdos kantota ple. Regotari angre robzantle okramdoske. Rebzuzu and kokna okramdos kantota pro. E paruta pa. Regzuzu and kento tre. Let no one return the same from this service this morning. Zetuni angrebdos. Zitla eklamdota. Rabzu zazuklemdo. Rekno enkramdoske. Rekno ekramdoske. Somebody is pressing his way into his next breakthrough in the realm of the spirit. Zelto lambro zeklekto skantonta lagno emponta rekando pre regzo ekrando zaltuta pa rekotla ekando liangrebdos e karuta pare lekno baruta kankro. Father, we thank you. In Jesus' mighty name we are prayed. We declare this service open in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Jam your hands together with Jesus' joy as you welcome the choir.
You can make those hands bigger for Jesus. Put those hands together for Jesus. He's worthy. Hallelujah. Let's lift up the hands to heaven and just wave to the Lord. Appreciate him. He's worthy. Glorious God, beautiful King, excellent God, I bow before your throne. Glorious God, beautiful King, excellent God, I bow before your throne. Glorious,
glorious God,
you are so beautiful. Come on, wave those hands and appreciate him. He's a glorious God. Glorious,
glorious God.
Beautiful.
Beautiful.
You are excellent.
Excellent God. I bow before your throne.
Bow before your throne. Together for him is worthy. Hallelujah. Oh Lord. Etobi. Etobi. Oh. Etobi. Oh Lord. Etobi. Etobi. Oh. Etobi. Oh Lord. Put your hands together. God in the highest.
Hallelujah.
Hey, glory, glory.
To the Lord.
Glory, glory.
We exalt your name.
Somebody exalt Jesus.
We exalt
Comfortably be seated in God's presence. Glory be to God. On behalf of God, the owner of the church, and our Father in the house, Pastor Adekunle Shinyobade, you are welcome to our Covenant Day of Exemption and also our special anointing service in the name of Jesus Christ. Glory be to God. Our call to worship this morning shall be taken from the book of Psalm 124. Psalm 124. From verse 1 to the end. Psalm 124 from verse 1 to the end. I take one, you take two, then we'll take the last one together. If it has not been the Lord who was on our side, now may Israel say, verse 2. Let's add flesh to it, hallelujah. Then they have swallowed us up quick when their wrath was kindled against us, verse 4. Then the proud waters has gone over our soul, verse 6. Our soul is escaped as a bird out of the snare of the fowlers. The snare is broken and we are escaped, verse 8 together. It's in the name of the Lord who made heaven and earth. May the Lord bless the reading of his word in the name of Jesus Christ. Are you clapping for Jesus?
Praise the Lord, I am more than a conqueror. I didn't hear your response. I said, praise the Lord, I am more than a conqueror. Congratulations. Shortly, we are rising to take this prayer number one. In this glorious first service, as we rise, we pray to us, Father, in the name of your Son, Jesus, endue every winner with the spirit of love, thereby keeping our zeal for your kingdom, ever burning in Jesus' name. Psalm 699 said, for the zeal of thine house hath eaten me up, and the reproaches of them that reproach thee are fallen upon me. I know you are ready to pray. Please rise on your feet. Lift up your voice. Father, in the name of your glorious Son, Jesus, endue every winner with the spirit of love, thereby keeping our zeal for your kingdom ever burning. You know that you are living there. You are going to be left alone. Please lift up the voice. Let your Father hear you pray. Are you sure you are praying? Lift up the voice and repeat the prayer, Father, in the name of your Son, Jesus. Endue every winner with the spirit of love, thereby keeping our zeal for your kingdom ever burning. Say it loud and say it clear. Let your Father in heaven hear your voice. Father, in the name of your Son, Jesus, endue me. Personalize the prayer, endue me with the spirit of love, thereby keeping my zeal for your kingdom ever burning. Lift up your two hands, give him praise. Give him thanks, give him glory. For we know that God has answered our prayers. For so shall it be. And in Jesus' mighty name we have prayed. Give a clap offering for Jesus. Please, you may be seated.
Praise the Lord, our mother, the conqueror. Amen and amen. Surely we shall be rising up to pray this prayer number two. When we rise up, we are going to say to our Father, in the name of Jesus, let there be speedy delivery of the 2022 more than a conqueror prophetic agenda in all aspects of our life. Praise the Lord. Bible speaking in Numbers chapter 23 and verse 19. He says, God is not a man that he should lie, neither the son of a man that he should repent. Had he said, and shall he not do it? Or has he spoken, and shall he not make it good? Praise the Lord. Shall we rise up our feet and begin to say, Father, in the name of Jesus, let there be speedy delivery of the 2022 more than a conqueror prophetic agenda in all aspects of our life. Pray that prayer right now. Lord, let there be spirit delivery. Lord, let there be spirit delivery. In the name of Jesus, let there be spirit delivery of the 2022 prophetic agenda. Ekatalia dorobush, imbragada lagaba, eketeli bradagabusha, masiateli gayada, ekatalia lagaba, eketeli brologorobush, bragatalia lagaba, yato sokotoleba. I believe you are praying. Father, in the name of Jesus, let there be speedy delivery of the 2022 more than a conqueror prophetic agenda in all aspects of our life. Are you praying that prayer? Talk to your Father right now. Lord, let there be speedy delivery. Lord, let there be speedy delivery of the 2022 prophetic agenda in the name of Jesus. Lord, we give you praise. Lord, in the name of Jesus, let there be the delivery of the prophetic agenda. In the name of Jesus, Lord, come this year, that shall be a delivery. In the name of Jesus, Ebragada lagaba, Esokodia delegabush, Embragada lagaba, Ricata lagaba. Let there be speedy delivery. Let there be speedy delivery. Let there be speedy delivery. In the name of Jesus, Malia deliada lagaba. Somebody praying, lift up your hands, begin to appreciate this God. He says, when we pray, we believe and have received. Lift up your hands and appreciate him, because all through this year, there shall be a delivery of the prophetic agenda, more than a conqueror, as God's servant has declared by the Holy Spirit. Appreciate God. Give him praise. He's a prayer answering God, a covenant keeping God. Father, we return all the glory to you this morning. Blessed be thy name. For in Jesus' wonderful name, we have prayed. Put those wonderful hands together to Jesus. You may be seated.
Praise the Lord, I am more than a conqueror.
It is announcement for today, Sunday, 20th February 2022. Are we clapping for Jesus? Praise the Lord. Today is our covenant day of exemption and also doubles as our special Sunday anointing service. Expect God's hand of protection to come upon you in this service in Jesus' name. Praise the Lord. Covenant hour of prayer holds every day, Monday to Saturday at the main church auditorium. Take advantage of this opportunity for your spiritual growth. The time is 6 to 7 a.m. Believers Foundation class. Our Believers Foundation class holds today immediately after the second and third services at the Information Center. All first-timers, new converts, and those who are yet to go through these specialized classes should be in attendance. Please, all those who come to church with new members and converts are encouraged to wait for them while they attend the class. Midweek Communion Service. Our Midweek Communion Service holds this Wednesday, 23rd February 2022. We shall be waiting on the Lord in a fast and come back to church to break with the communion. The time is 4:30 p.m. Winner Satellite Fellowship. Our Winner Satellite Fellowship holds every Saturday in all our locations across the town. Locate the nearest center to you and attend. Everyone who wants to host the Ark of God's presence, that is Winner Satellite Fellowship in their home, should pick the form from the ushers. Please be reminded that we shall be taking our welfare offering in this service. This is to help the needy and sow a transport seat for those coming from far distance. The Gilead Medical Team is inviting all new and old members to her general meeting immediately after the third service today. The venue is Gilead Center. The Deacons Assembly General Meeting for the month of February 2022 shall hold today after the third service at KHMS Building. Every worshiper is reminded that the faith entrance and the two entrances at the rear of the auditorium serves as our exit door after each service. This is to avoid collision of worshipers. God bless you as you obey orderliness in the house of God. God said, "He that honors me will I honor." We are required to adhere to the instructions of church officials in the course of our services, such as the traffic control unit, the crowd control unit, and other officials for orderliness. Please note that undue gathering, jesting, and meeting of any sort during service is a gross disregard to God and the church authority. However, we are advised to hold such meetings after the last service. God bless you. Good news. Next Sunday, 27th February 2022, shall be our covenant day of fruitfulness and also our end of the month Thanksgiving. If you are clapping, you can do that better. Next Sunday shall also feature family blessings. Don't leave any member of your family at home. Also come with your friends, neighbors, and converts. First service is 6:30 a.m., second service 8:15 a.m., and third service is 10 a.m. Operation One Winner, One Soul every month. In line with the prophetic mandate of the year, every winner is expected to win at least one soul for Christ each month in order to enjoy the blessedness of Operation One Winner, One Soul every month. Invite someone to church, direct your converts, and ensure your neighbor join our highly transforming services. Don't miss the midweek service on Wednesday, which is communion. It is a platform for your spiritual growth and a gain higher authority in your walk with God. Jesus is Lord. Let's clap for Jesus.
Shout hallelujah. God speaking in his word. He said, "Look unto me and it shall be evident unto you if I lied." Praise God. It is testimony time. Please, let's put our hands together as we welcome Elder Mrs. Rita Uvere as she comes forward for her testimony. Please, let's keep clapping as she's coming while we listen to these documented testimonies. Divine exemption and promotion. I joined this commission in 2007 by the leading of the Holy Spirit. In 2008, tagged on eagle's wings, I keyed into all the prophecies here. And through that, God led me to the organization where I work presently. I joined the organization as a janitor supervisor, but in 5 years, I got different promotions by engaging in kingdom service. Also, in January, I gave my Shiloh sacrifice, and that same year, the bishop declared the blessings of the midst of the year, after which I got double promotion in July. I got an award, Long Service Award. However, in March 2014, 12 people were laid off in my office, but God exempted me. After the retrenchment, the managing director called and addressed us and said, the reason others were retrenched was because the company was about to fold up, but there are some of you that if we let you go, the company will fail. Those who are left are part of that group. I give all the glory to the Lord for making me part of the people that will save the company. And the testifier is Winnie S. Come forward. Your name and precisely what the Almighty God did.
Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. My name is Elder Mrs. Rita Uvere. I have come here to testify the goodness of the Lord in my life and my family. I've come to say, Almighty God, the God of all flesh, covenant-keeping God, God that never fails, great I am that I am, unchangeable God, reliable God, is my Father, is my God, is our God, is our Father. I've come to return all the glory in Jesus' mighty name. During the week of fasting and praying, a call came that one of my daughters was admitted in the hospital. I didn't know what else to do. My heart failed me. I was even staggering. I didn't know what to do. But I hold on to the word of God that comes from this pulpit. My plan is in the book of life, from the book. But with prayer and fasting and other men of God praying, my daughter went for that surgery, a heavy surgical operation that it will only take God for people to come out from theater. I thank God because God has done it. After that operation, she stood up. For 5 days, she couldn't walk. She couldn't walk. She couldn't eat anything. Prayer was going on. But later on, news came that she has stood up and she's now walking around. God had discharged him yesterday and has gone back to the family. I return all the glory to Almighty God. In Jesus' name, amen.
The Almighty God that intervened for the daughter will intervene for you in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Shall we listen to this second documented testimony? Supernatural deliverance. On Tuesday, the 12th of March, 2013, while in my shop, I brought out the flyers distributed in church the previous Sunday titled Covenant Day of Exemption. While reading the testimonies behind the flyer, two armed men suddenly approached me and said, Madam, we have arrested all your boys. Get up gently, follow us, and don't make noise. On our way, I held the flyer and prayed. I said, God, what you did for these two brethren that I read their testimonies, you must surely do it for me. I am a winner. I am not permitted to die like this. On Sunday, my husband came to Canaan land and told the bishop that I have been kidnapped. The bishop shouted and said, no, it cannot happen. He commanded my release, and that was it. On Tuesday, the 19th of March, we were released and given money for transportation. I give all the glory to God. The testifier is Ugochukwu M. In your seated position, shall we appreciate this good God for what he has done for our brethren. Lord, we give you thanks and praise in the name of Jesus Christ.
For all those wonderful testimonies, one more time, why don't you put your hands together for Jesus? Hallelujah. In this covenant day of exemption, it is offering time. In the book of Acts of the Apostle, chapter 20, verse 35, scripture says, I have showed you all things, how that so laboring ye ought to support the weak, and to remember the words of our Lord Jesus, how he said, it is more blessed to give than to receive. I believe you are set to give in obedience to his word this morning. You have your tithe, your offering, Shiloh sacrifice, chariot of fire seed, or any other seed you have proposed to give to your God this morning, please begin to package them excitedly. Please understand that this is different from the welfare offering as was announced earlier. This is the usual regular offering. Please package them gracefully. Rise on your feet. For those of us that are giving online, please take advantage of the account details displayed on the screen for our online giving. Lift it high above your head and begin to water that seed in your hand this morning with the fruit of your lips. Heavenly Father, I have come in obedience to your word even this morning. Accept this seed at my hand and let it, Lord, ascend unto you as a sweet smelling savour. Heavenly Father, this seed now in your hand this morning is declared blessed in the mighty name of Jesus. As you give this seed this morning, every form of suffering is terminated from your destiny. In Jesus' precious name. Please be comfortably seated. Cast your seed as we welcome the ministry of the choir.
Not a move. my head, my head. Begin to appreciate him. Our help can only come from him. All our help can only come from him. Say, shall I look up my eyes unto the hills? From whence cometh my help? Say, my help cometh from the Lord, which made the heavens and the earth. Say, he that keepeth thee will not suffer thee to be moved. That shall be your story. Lift up your voice, appreciate him. Father, we give you praise. Lord, we worship you. Lord, we exalt your majesty. Sweet Holy Spirit, the supreme intelligence, minister to us at this point in time. Convict every sinner. Convict every sinner. Show us the righteousness of Jesus and impending judgment, O Lord. Let your name alone be glorified. For in Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Put your hand together for Jesus and comfortably have your seat in God's presence. I count it a great privilege given to me by God's servant to take the word in this first service on this covenant day of exemption. You shall be exempted from all the calamities and calamitous of events in our country today. Because you are the redeemed, you are exempted. Your amen is weak. And so shall it be. Continuing with our prophetic focus, the faith secures the fulfillment of prophecy. Luke 1:45, your belief is what that will provoke the performance of what God has spoken. As you believe, that is a chain to provoke the performance as it came to pass in the life of Mary. Our teaching series that has been running till this Sunday is engaging the power of faith for the fulfillment of prophecy. Faith has inbuilt power to cause prophecy to come to pass. And when we engage, you say we're engaging. Until we engage, it shall not come to pass. In those days when we were riding manual vehicles, when you start your car, until you engage gear one, boom. It will jack, boom. You move and you, two, three, four, in that order. Engaging the power of faith for the fulfillment of prophecy. As a matter of introduction, say prophecies are the unveiling of God's plan and purpose for a people or an individual. Engaging prophecy and the unveiling of God's purpose. God has a purpose for us. In the winner's family, what is the purpose of God for us? What is the prophecy for us? In the year 2022, God spoke through his servant that we are more than a conqueror. That we are what? More than a conqueror. God's servant, the resident pastor, explained to us what it means to be more than a conqueror. He said, after the warfare had been done, man has gone to war. And when they come back, you are there keeping watch, then they will give you the spoils of war. That is being more than a conqueror. They are the ones that went and conquered. Then you partake in the spoils of war. That shall be your portion this time around. In the mighty name of Jesus, corroborating it in John chapter 4, 37, say, and herein is the saying true, one soweth and another reapeth. I sent you to reap that wherein you bestowed no labor. Other men labored, and you are entered into their labor. That shall be your story this time around. You shall enter into that place you have not labored because of the prophecy of the season. That shall be your portion in Jesus' name. What more, it is our year of unforgettable and undeniable breakthrough. More than a conqueror. It is also our year of boat sinking testimonies, net breaking testimonies, favor without measure. Did you understand me? Favor without measure. These are what God has prepared for us in the package of the year 2022. Blessings without sorrow. Praise the Lord. Therefore, God speaking in Ezekiel chapter 12, verse 25. Can the studio just give me Ezekiel 12, 25? Praise the Lord. Say, for I am the Lord. I will speak, and the word that I shall speak shall come to pass. If you believe that, say amen. It shall be no more prolonged. For in your days, O rebellious house, you are not rebellious, will I say the word and will perform it, saith the Lord. God is saying, I will speak, and the word I speak shall come to pass in your lives. It shall no longer be prolonged. There shall be no delay. There shall be no denial any longer. In the name of Jesus. The prophecy shall come with speed of the Spirit. It shall come with the speed of the Spirit. Because we are more than a conqueror. Hallelujah. Listen, my brethren. This morning, every sent word through the mouth of your servant to us will perform, will receive speed in your life. We have gathered to receive from him. There's something we receive in the sanctuary that you cannot receive anywhere. There's something you receive in the sanctuary. Say, in your presence, there is fullness of joy. And your right hand, there are pleasures forevermore. You can't receive this in the bank. You can't receive it in the hotel. You can't receive it in the filling station. Fullness of joy. Fullness of joy is what you will receive as you are here. Today, that expectation of yours shall be fulfilled in Jesus' name. So the Bible, there are three major sources of prophecy. We shall rush it because we know all these things. Number one, one source of prophecy is the Bible. In 2 Peter 1:19, say that the Bible is a more sure word of prophecy. What do we see from the Bible? The Bible will show you the plan of God for your life. Number two, the Bible will show you the principles for a victorious living. Many Christians have been living but without victory. You get it from the Bible. The principles for a victorious living. It will correct you. It will direct you. That is why it is necessary that we read and study our Bible. That is one source of prophecy. Number two is through personal encounter with God, as in the case of Abraham and Moses. Another source of prophecy is through personal encounter. In Genesis chapter 12, verses 1 through 3, God speaking to Abraham. Said Abraham, say, here am I. Say, get thee out of your country, your kindred, your father's house, to a place I will show you. I'll bless you, I'll multiply you, I'll make you rich. And whosoever you bless is blessed. And whosoever you curse is cursed. And whosoever curseth you is finished already. If you believe that, say amen. So through personal encounter with God, Abraham had it. And that's another source of prophecy. Moses also, when God saw the affliction of the people of Israel, he said, wow, Moses, come. I will send you. I've heard their cry. When you cry, don't think God is not hearing. Shout amen. Say, I've heard their cry, like what is happening in our nation today. I've heard their cry, and I will send you to be an undertaker. And that is why God is sending us consistently on outreaches to be undertaker, to ensure that the rest of our brethren are rescued. Exodus 3, 7 to 10. Number 3, true God sent prophets, as in the case of the widow of Zarephath and Elijah. Another source of prophecy is through the sent prophet of God. Elijah was sent to the widow of Zarephath in Luke chapter 4, 25 to 27. During the famine, in no other place was Elijah sent except to Zarephath. Praise the Lord. Say, but I tell you, but unto none of them, hallelujah, studio. But I tell you of the truth, many widows were in Israel in the days of Elias, when the heavens were shut up 3 years and 6 months, when great famine was throughout the land. But none of them was Elijah sent to except the woman of Zarephath. God visited that. And again, many lepers were in Israel. None was Elisha sent except Naaman, the Syrian captain. God shall visit you this time. In the time of trouble, he selects those he visits. And because you are the redeemed, you shall be selected. Amen. In the mighty name of Jesus. Therefore, today, what are we discussing today? Engaging the power of faith for the fulfillment of prophecy, part 3. How powerful are prophecies? How powerful are prophecies? Number 1, God speaks according to his almighty power. Praise the Lord. God does what? Speaks according to his almighty power. In Revelation chapter 19, verse 6, the Bible says God thunders. He speaks in the form of thunder, according to his strength, according to his inbuilt capacity. He says, I'm not a man that I should lie, nor the son of man that I should change my mind. I have the inbuilt capacity as I speak for it to come to pass. If we look at it again in Psalm 105, verses 19 to 23, Psalm 105, 19 to 23, he said, until the time that his word came, the word of God tried him, speaking about Joseph. He speaks. The king sent for him and loosed him, even the ruler of the people, and let him go free. Every bandage, everywhere where you have been chained, you are loose this morning. Said the king sent for him, loosed him, and let him go free. 21 says he made him lord of his house and ruler of all his substance, to bind his princes at his pleasure, and to teach his senators wisdom. God speaks according to his almighty power. When God speaks concerning you, nothing on planet earth can stop it. And that shall be your case in the name of Jesus. Men may have promised you something, but they don't have the capacity. You may have a friend to a governor and say, come. The new contract to build 1,000 police unit of houses will be yours. Come by Monday to pick the, sign the contract paper. By midnight, he's removed. And when you come, it will not happen. But God, when God tells you, come by tomorrow, it shall be fulfilled. I say, when God speaks to you, because it has an inbuilt capacity, it shall come to pass in Jesus' name. How powerful are prophecies? Number 2, God speaks according to his creative wisdom. according to his creative wisdom, has the power to create. He was moving, he saw Peter and the rest, John and others, settling after toiling. Say, brethren, do you have anything? They said, nothing. We have tried everywhere. In John chapter 21, 5 to 6, and nothing happened. He said, then cast your net on the right side. For any experienced fisherman, what is the difference between right and left? There's no difference. But they obeyed, and when they were obeying, God called a congregation of the fish, the political heavyweights, those that want to be governor and all this, yeah, give your manifesto. As they were gathering to give their manifesto, the net went there, Izam. And what happened? It gathered them. And the net began to break. By the wisdom of God, this season shall be your net-breaking testimonies. God does it by his wisdom, by his creative wisdom. Say, cast your net. And they did it. And it came to pass. Also, God had the creative ability. In Genesis chapter 1, 11 and 12, he said, let the earth burst forth with herbs, with trees, with plants. And they began to burst forth. In your life today, what is that organ in your system that refused to work? The creative wisdom of God is reaching out to you right now. That failed organ, receive strength now. That dead organ, be recreated now. That health challenge, be destroyed now. In the name of Jesus. That's the creative wisdom of God. It's an exclusive preserve of Jehovah God. No one debates that with him. Shout hallelujah. God will do it for you in Jesus' name. How does faith facilitate the fulfillment of prophecy? Faith is a test to pass to see any prophetic word come to pass. Faith is a test to pass. You need to pass the test of faith to see any prophecy come to pass. It came to pass when the children of Israel were moving to possess the promised land, as recorded in Numbers chapter 13, 23 to 33. Moses sent them to spy, and they came back with a result. 12 people went. 10 brought evil report. 2 said, never. It cannot be. There was a test. 10 failed. 2 passed. In Numbers chapter 14, verses 6, Joshua told them, the land is a good land. Shout hallelujah. And Joshua, the son of Nun, and Caleb, the son of Jephunneh, which were of them that searched the land, rent their clothes, and said what? That the land is what? A good land. Verse 9. Hallelujah. Verse 9. Studio. I have my Bible on. Praise the Lord. Say, only rebel not against the Lord, and fear not their fear. Only rebel not against the Lord, and don't be afraid of them. Say, we are able to possess the land. And what did God say? In Numbers 31, verses 23. Numbers 31, verse 23. Studio. Everything that may abide, that you make it go through. No. Shout hallelujah. I have it here. Praise the Lord. Numbers 14, please. Verse 23. Numbers 14, verse 23. Can we have it? Say, surely they shall not see the land which I swear unto their fathers, neither shall any of them that provoked me to see it. Up, studio. Hallelujah. But my servant Caleb, because he had another spirit with him and had followed me fully, him will I bring into the land where into he went, and his seed shall possess it. When you begin to obey God, The advantage is not only for you, it will include your seed. Your seed shall be a beneficiary. Caleb and Joshua passed the test and were what? Promoted. Why the other thing? God said they will die in the wilderness. For us, because we will never fear their fear, because we will never doubt God, we shall possess the land in Jesus' name. So we must continue to treasure prophetic words. For them to come to pass, please. We must treasure prophetic words. What does it mean? You must believe in it. What is treasure? Treasure is something you cherish. When we are small in those days, when we have box, they call portmanteau, you have a peculiar dress. After Christmas, after Sunday service, you just piala the dress. You know what is called piala? Shout hallelujah. You just fold the dress and put in the down box again because it's a treasure. See, we should treasure prophetic words. We should believe prophetic words. As we believe prophetic words, so it shall work for us in Jesus' name. We must engage faith-filled thoughts. Proverbs 4:23. Faith-filled thoughts. Praise the Lord. Faith-filled thoughts. Say, keep thy heart with all diligence, because out of it are the issues of life. And it says in Proverbs again, your heart is the seat of every thought. You drive away anything that will bring down your faith. There are friends that will discuss with you and your faith will collapse. Run away from such people. Faith-filled thoughts. Ensure you build your heart on faith-filled thoughts. Proverbs 23:7. Say, as a man thinketh in his heart, so is he. In one of our platforms in our neighborhood, one man, if you see what he writes, that it shows exactly who he is. Nonsense every time. Nonsense. As a man thinketh in his heart. That is why you must guide your heart not to think any manner. You must think right. If you think right, you see right. In Jesus' name. We must engage in faith-driven action. Anna refused to give up. After Shiloh, Anna said, I must be blessed. I'll never go until I'm blessed. In 1 Samuel chapter 1, 14 and 15. Anna was kabashing until the priest saw the mouth. As he saw the man, said, woman, won't you get out of here? He said, never. I'm not drunk. I'm a woman of sorrowful spirit. He said, wow. Let the God of Israel do it according to her desire. I stand on that same authority and say, whatever is that thing that have been bothering your heart, because you are here, you will never live the same. May the God of this commission give it to you. May the God of this commission give it to you. Because God is a God of wisdom. And by him, actions are weighed. Let me tell us something. Your action is being weighed by God. As we are speaking, more than a conqueror, unbeatable testimony, you say amen. And when you go back home, you begin to sorrow. Your action is what God is seeing. Do you believe it? What's the action speaking? Say, let the sick say, I'm strong. You say, I'm strong. Yet you are lying down, covering yourself, binding yourself and shaking. They say, I'll say, I'm strong. Say, God is a God of wisdom. By him, actions are weighed. From today, your action shall receive answer. In the mighty name of Jesus, we must be rest assured of the end result. Hallelujah. In Psalm 89, verses 34. In Psalm 89, verse 34, say, my covenant will I not break, nor alter the things that is gone out of my mouth. What is God saying? Every word moving is prophetic. Say, what I've said, I will not break. I will ensure it is fulfilled on your behalf. If that is so, you don't need to doubt. From today, every spirit of doubt, every spirit of doubt is bound in the name of Jesus. I want you to lift up your hand and say, God, from today, doubt is out of my life. I must believe you, God, because you say your covenant you'll never break. If you will not break it, then I will not be the one to break it. Father, we thank you, for in Jesus' mighty name we have prayed. Quickly, today is our covenant of exemption. Can we put our hand together for Jesus? God, who exempted his people from all plagues that took place in Egypt, is still same today. Malachi 3:6. I am the Lord, I change not, and because of you, you sons of winners shall not be consumed. Say, I'm the Lord, I change not, therefore you sons of Jacob are not consumed. God is speaking as he did it for them in the land of Israel. He will do it for you even today. He shall exempt you from all calamities prevalent in Nigeria today. There are a lot of calamities, be it rampant disregard to value of life and properties. You see people maiming and killing anyhow. Young boy, 17 to 19 years, gotten a young girl, killed her, cut off her head, boiling the head to eat for ritual sake. And God said, that type of, you are exempted from that obnoxious activities. Amen. Your children will never be caught. Amen. Your siblings shall never be caught. Amen. Your family shall never be caught. Amen. In the name of Jesus. Amen. God's exemption plan, say, will do. All number two says, from every collapse of business and career. When the men say they are falling up, down, you say they are what? Rising up. When there is downsizing in your place of work, then you will begin to receive promotions. If you believe that, say amen. Amen. When there is downsizing, you will be receiving upsizing. In Jesus' name. Every form of devastation and destruction in the form of unknown gunmen, banditry, Boko Boko, Ebubagu, and so on, shall not see you. Amen. These are devastations that are happening now. Until you are secured, they may take over you. But that shall not be your story. Amen. Every form of frustration, stagnation, and disappointment, and even sudden death, God said, you are exempted. He said, you are exempted in the name of Jesus. But redemption is the mark of our exemption from all evils in this wicked world. What is the mark? Redemption. Redemption is the prerequisite. For anyone to enter into a Nigerian university or higher institution, you must pass your school cert and you must pass your JAMB. So redemption is synonymous to school start and jam. For you to be exempted, you are here to this morning, and you need to be exempted from all this evil. Then, pick redemption. Be born again today in the mighty name of Jesus. And the Bible says in 2 Corinthians 5:17, praise the Lord, said, therefore, if any man is in Christ, he's a new creature. All things are passed away. Behold, all things have become new. Today, that addiction, that indulgence, as you surrender your life, they shall pass away. Amen. I said, they shall pass away. Amen. How do we experience our exemption rights? Quickly, we must have a revelation of exemption right in Christ. We must do what? Have a revelation of exemption right in Christ. In Isaiah 5:13, say, my people go into captivity for lack of knowledge. You must have the revelation of exemption, right? That is, if you're born again, you are entered. You're exempted. Shout hallelujah. Colossians 1:13 said, he delivered us from the power of darkness and transferred us into the kingdom of his dear son. These are rights and privileges that you need to exercise. You need to exercise it. Number two, we must keep the love of God alive in our heart to actualize our exemption heritage, the love of God. In Psalm 91, verse 14 says, because he has shown his love upon me, he has set his love upon me, therefore will I deliver him. God is set to deliver you. Let your heart be filled with love. Let your heart be filled with love. Romans 8:28 say, all things work together for the good of them that love God and them that are called according to his purpose. When you love God, things will come together to do you good. I said, to do what? To do you good. To do what? To do you good. 1 Corinthians 2:9 says, eyes have not seen nor ear heard what God has prepared for them that love him. I believe you are a lover of God. Let the lovers of God wave their hand unto Jesus. Hallelujah. We must remain dedicated to kingdom advancement endeavor. Hallelujah. Kingdom advancement endeavor is the jackpot. Yesterday, we went on district outreaches. How many went? Kingdom advancement outreach, kingdom advancement prayers, kingdom advancement visitation, calls, all manner. In Exodus 25:23, say, and you shall serve the Lord, and the Lord shall bless your bread and your water, and shall take away. When you serve, sickness will disappear. Medicine for sickness is service. Shout hallelujah. The drug for abortion is service. The drug for stillbirth is service. The drug for longevity is what? Service. As you serve, you shall live long. I say you shall live long. I say you shall live long. And Jesus did it by sending them two by two. In Luke chapter 10, as they went, God gave them great harvest. They said, Satan obeyed us. We saw everything. He said, yes, because I am there with you. Say, I give unto you power. You shall trample upon serpent and scorpion. When you go out, the power will come. Shout amen. Amen. Whenever you go out, the power will come in the mighty name of Jesus. Finally, we must continue to speak openly of our exemption rights. Open thy mouth and I'll fill it. Psalm 81, verse 10 to 14. Speak boldly for exemption rights. Proverbs 18:21, death and life are in the power of the tongue. As you begin to speak, your exemption shall not be denied you. In the mighty name of Jesus, all heads bow, all eyes closed. You are here in this service. The grace of God that bringeth salvation is released. Titus 2:11, the grace of God is released for salvation. And salvation, which is redemption, is the key to exemption. My brother, my sister, I beg of you, you are not saved. You need to be exempted from the calamities, all manner that is happening in our nation now. You need to be exempted, then you must be saved. See, as many as received him, to them he gave the power to become the sons of God. You have heard this word, you want to be exempted. Can I see your hand up? Wherever you are seated, you want to be exempted from all the calamities and the dangers in our nation. You want to be exempted to stand and enjoy the more than a conqueror prophetic agenda for the year 2022. If you are that one, can you rise on your feet and say after me, Lord Jesus, I have heard your word. I know I cannot help myself. Come into my life, Jesus. Save me. Cause me to partake of my exemption rights in the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you, my Father, for I am now born again. If you have prayed that prayer, can you just come forward? Come forward, begin to come, choir. As choir begin to minister, come forward, please. You pray this prayer, leave your seat and march forward here. Come forward to be promoted. come forward to receive the seal of God.
Lord,
if you are clapping, clap well for Jesus choir.
I give you my soul. I live for you alone. Every breath that I take, every moment I'm
Father, we thank you for these souls. They have come to surrender to you. Lord, none of them shall return back to their vomit in the name of Jesus Christ. Holy Spirit of God, we hand over these souls to you. Take absolute control, for in Jesus' mighty name we pray. Congratulations, you made a wise decision. Please turn this way. Follow the covenant, friends. Follow the covenant, friends. Hallelujah. Put your hands together for Jesus, for that powerful word of God. You've been blessed. Make those hands bigger and bigger for Jesus. And please have your seat in God's presence. We're about to partake of the anointing. Saul partook of the anointing and three different things occurred to him. This morning, as we partake of the anointing, these are the things we expect. Number one, the anointing of God this morning will bring about exemption from accidents, exemption from untimely deaths, exemption from kidnapping, exemption from ritual activities, in the name of Jesus Christ. I say in the name of Jesus Christ, what is in the anointing is the yoke-destroying power of God. In Isaiah chapter 10, 25 and 27, we say, for yet a little while, and indignation shall cease, and my anger in their destruction. If you check the things happening in our society, wickedness on the increase on a daily basis, and God is telling you his wrath will arise against the wicked, and the Lord of hosts shall stir up a scourge of him according to the slaughter of Midian at the rock of Oreb, and as his wrath was upon the sea, so shall he lift it up after the man of Egypt. He said, and it shall come to pass in that day, today is that day, that his burden shall be taken away from off thy shoulder, and his yoke from off thy neck, and the yoke shall be destroyed because of what? The anointing. There are people still suffering under certain habits, certain things you wish not to do, but you see yourself doing it. Certain things you have made decisions based on discipline to overcome, but you see yourself returning to them. By the anointing this morning, such yokes shall be destroyed in the name of Jesus Christ. I say such yokes shall be destroyed in the name of Jesus Christ. There are people suffering under fear. They come to church, they hear the word of God, they are afraid. Afraid of who knows what I'll remain in my parents' house and get old. Look at my age, I'm already 31. Some are afraid of their past, what they did in the past. Who knows why I am not yet pregnant because of the abortion I committed during my university days. The Bible says, shall the lawful captive be delivered? He said, even the captive of the mighty shall be delivered. He said, I will contend with him that contend with you, and I will save your children. The devil is accused of the brethren. Lord, don't do this thing for him or for her because of this and this he has committed or he has committed. If, for instance, somebody complained in this service that I'm looking for my phone. My phone is missing. I will start searching. We'll lock up the entire entrance. Nobody is living here. We must find the phone. And all of a sudden, we find the phone in one young guy's pocket. Ah, we have caught the thief. This is a thief. We have caught him. He said, for this phone he stole, let's lock him in this old office in the toilet. Then I now give order, we pick him up, lock him in the toilet, lock him inside there. And then he remains there. He is a lawful captive. We have held him captive because of what he has committed, the phone he has stolen. And all of a sudden, they say, pastor arrives now, and they say, what is happening here? Why is everywhere noisy? Say, sir, we caught a thief. During service, we caught a thief, red-handed. Where is he? He's in the restroom. We lock him up there. In answer, yeah, release him. Let him go. Praise God. We say, no, he's not going anywhere. Are we going to say, no, he's not going anywhere? He should remain there. Praise God. No, definitely, the higher authority has come and he has said, let him go. In spite of what he's told, in spite of the fact we caught him red-handed, we'll let him go free of charge. Praise God. That same way, there are people that have committed one atrocity or the other. You broke somebody's heart and the person say, over my dead body, will you find love in your life? Over my dead body, will you succeed? You defrauded me. Let me see how finance will remain in your hands. They did one thing or the other against your finance, against your marriage, against your career, against your fruitfulness. And God is telling you, because of the anointing, every yoke, every utterance, every curse that be released upon you shall be destroyed. That's why he says, shall the lawful captive be delivered? He said, even the captive of the mighty shall be delivered. I will contend with him that contend with you, and I'll save your children. It will not only be you, even your children. That thing I've been running from generation to generation. Everyone suffering the same thing. By the anointing, it shall come to an end. I say, by the anointing, it shall come to an end. There are people, their own challenge is ignorance. First of all, fear. Fear prevents you from seizing opportunities. Some, their own is ignorance. In my place, this is not how we do it. Where we come from, this is not how we do it. Ignorance have kept many believers on the same spot. Ignorance prevents you from making good decisions. So by this anointing, every spirit of ignorance will be destroyed. Another one, there are people, believers, their challenge is anger. Anger prevents you from seeing clearly. You are angry. Because you are angry, you can't take sound decision. Anger is their challenge. They are living a holy life, but their major challenge is anger. The anointing will destroy every spirit of anger this morning. In the name of Jesus Christ. There are people who are born again, but they are envious. Envy. Envy prevents you from focusing on yourself. You focus on others. Can't you see they made this one deacon? Can't you see a whole, I've stayed 10 years. This one just came 3 years ago. They have made him deacon because he has a car. So that envy, anything the person does, you are angry. There are people that when they hear others share testimonies, they are angry. I've had a particular young man, somebody saw her in a church, the same living church on my previous station. And they said, this man is very diligent. I like the way he walks. I love the way he sounds. I want to pick him up to go and serve, to work for me in my company. Another believer that I heard, he said, this one, don't try it. This guy, don't try it. Don't send him. Even though he's diligent, even though he's hardworking, he likes women. He will pursue all the women in your company. He will pursue all the women. They say, is that true? That was how the young man lost the job. There are people who are envious of others. I don't want this person to be better than me. And because of it, they have remained where they are. In Igbo, they say, Ojonyenala, Jonwea. If you are fighting and then I'm holding you on the floor, you're not going anywhere, I'm not going anywhere. Let's assume I'm fighting with Pastor Kemka and then we are holding ourselves here on the floor. Church dismisses, everybody have gone. We are still here. You have gone home, you are rested, but we are still here, holding ourselves here. Praise God. So you are holding someone in your heart. You are holding someone down. You are not making progress. There is no way your prayers will be answered. So the anointing this morning will destroy all these faces. We have people who their own is pride is their challenge. Some own, their own is hatred. Some own is lying. Some own, their own is what? Unforgiveness. These are all challenges that kept believers on the same spot. So by this anointing this morning, they shall all be destroyed. Rise up on your feet and stretch out your hands towards this anointing. I don't know the area you need God's intervention. I don't know the area. The anointing will crush every sickness. The anointing this morning will bring about a mark of exemption upon you. The anointing this morning will bring about a change of story. Stretch out your hands towards this anointing. Lord, as I partake of it, anything buying and selling in my system, in my body, Lord, let it be crushed. Is someone praying this morning? In Isaiah 54 verse 17, it is what you declare that is clear for you. He said, no weapon that is formed against thee shall prosper, and every tongue that shall rise against thee in judgment, thou shalt condemn. You are the one to condemn it. You are the one to condemn it. Everything the enemy has planned against you, against your family, against any member of your family, Lord, I cancel it. 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 By this anointing, let every appointment with accident, by this anointing, let every appointment with untimely death, by this anointing, let every orchestration from the pit of hell be destroyed, be destroyed, be destroyed. Father, we declare this blessed and sanctified. The name of God, the Father, of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Lord, we declare blessed. We declare sanctified. In the name of Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name. Please have your seats. And then as you anoint yourself, you start declaring what you want. As you anoint yourself, my finance is turning. My health is coming back. The spirit of wisdom is released upon me. The spirit of sound mind. The spirit of forgiveness. The spirit of love. The spirit of giving is released. Choir. Okay.
Now that the battle is over. Now that the battle is over.
Now as you anoint yourself, begin to declare. Over. Anything you want, declare it.
I am more than a conqueror. Lord, lift your voice.
Now that the battle is over.
Oh.
I am more than a conqueror.
Now that the battle is over.
battle is over. Now your battle is over. You are more than a conqueror. In your finance, in your health, in your marriage, in your career, in your academics, you are more than a conqueror. In the name of Jesus Christ, as we have declared it, so shall it be. For in Jesus' mighty name we pray. Put your hands together for Jesus and gloriously have your seats in God's presence. We want to welcome those who are worshiping with us for the first time. The Bible says the step of a righteous man is ordered by God. God is the one. Man might have invited you, but God is the one that ordered your step. Today is your first time in our midst. Just wave your hand that place you are seated. Just wave your hand. Today is your first time. Just wave your hand where you are seated. Please pick your bags and your Bible, whatever you came to church with. Come forward. We'd like to pray for you specially. Pick your bag, your Bible. Come forward. Those around them, encourage them. Pick everything you came to church with. We have come to the end of the service. And come forward. We'd like to pray for you specially. We'd like to pray for you specially. Pick your bags, your Bible, whatever you came to church with. And please come forward. We'd like to pray for you specially. Just face this way. Hallelujah. Jesus prayed for the man that was blind and asked him, can you see now? He said, yes, he can see men like trees. Praise God. He had to now touch him again the second time, then he could see clearly. The more you come, the more you're enlightened. The more you come, the clearer you see. Praise God. I know you have been blessed this morning. We wish to see you again and again. We worship here every Sunday. We have run three services here. And also on Wednesday, we fast. We meet by 4:30 p.m. I know your step has been ordered by God. Just stretch out your hands towards these ones. Release God's blessing. Release God's protection. They have stepped into winners. Cause them to win every battle of their life. They have come to a place of answers. Let answers come to them. Let solution come their way. Is someone praying for them? They have appeared before the altar of Jesus. Let everything concerning their destiny be altered for positive. Lord, we declare your blessing to rest upon this one. They have come to a place of glory, a place of honor. May honor follow them in the days of their life. May glory follow them all the days of their life. Thank you, ancient of days, for these ones. To you alone be all the glory. For in Jesus' mighty name we pray. Congratulations. We'd like to see you again and again. Please turn this way. Follow this covenant, friends. They'll put some information across you. Just go this way. God bless you. Church, if you're excited, keep clapping for them. Keep clapping, clapping, clapping for them. Hallelujah. Package your welfare offering, whatever you have come to honor God with. On the third Sunday of every month, we always give a welfare seat to those who are in need in our midst. So please, and also as chariots of fire seats to help transport people from far and near for service. So package it. You are here with your chariot of fire seat. You're here with your welfare offering. You want to put food on somebody's table. You want to help somebody's health. Those, we have series of letters across in the office. We are yet to settle many of them. So please, as God lays in your heart, you can write a check or you can give whatever God lays in your heart. And please, if you have done that, rise up on your feet. Jesus said, when you have given to the needy, you have lent to the Lord. You are borrowing to God. And then God does not procrastinate. He will always reward. As you're giving, he takes your name off from the list of the needy. Father, Lord, we thank you for everyone who have packaged one thing or the other to extend hand of fellowship to the needy. Lord, these ones, their names will not be among the list of the needy. Lord, by this offering, let every suffering be terminated. I declare those offerings blessed. God will return to you hundredfold, for in Jesus' mighty name we pray. Please give those offerings cheerfully as we invite the choir.
We are saying thank you. Jesus, thank you. Jehovah, thank you. Everybody saying thank you. Jesus, thank you. Thank you, Lord. We are saying thank you.
We are saying.
Jesus, thank you. Jehovah, thank you. Everybody saying thank you. Jesus, thank you. Thank you.
Hallelujah. We have come to the end of this service. Listen to the following announcement once again before we take our leave. Good news. Next Sunday is our end of the month Thanksgiving and also Covenant Day of Fruitfulness. So please, you have family Thanksgiving, you have special dedications, child dedication, or whatever Thanksgiving you want to do, please endeavor to register with the protocol, register in the office, and make sure that is duly done. Make sure you don't come to next service without a soul. Come with someone, and I see God honoring you in the name of Jesus Christ. Good news again. Good news. We have Wolfbee. The last Wolfbee for this quarter is coming up from 28th of February and end on 11th of March. Please, if you have done Wolfbee here, please stand up. If you have done Wolfbee, just 1 minute, stand up. If you have done Word of Faith Bible Institute, you have done Wolfbee, stand up. You have done Wolfbee, stand up. So, anyone that has not passed through that class is not yet considered as a winner. What makes you a true winner? Your ability to have undergone that class. If in most places, you're not allowed to join a unit when you have not done Wolfbee. Praise God. So you can see those cities. You can see those that have done. So you are missing something. Endeavor to register and God will honor you. So Wolfbee is starting off, not this tomorrow, upper Monday for the next week. Some people are already ongoing. Please sit down. God bless you. Please sit down. We are going to run BCC, that's Basic Certificate Course. And then you are here, you're a leader or you are designed to be a leader. You need to do Leadership Certificate Course. Leadership Certificate Course. Most time when they pick up 5 people's name for leadership, they check what is the person's will be qualification. If it's only BCC, someone that has LCC will be considered before you. Someone that has LDC will be considered before you, not minding how long you have stayed in church. So please, we're having BCC and LCC starting from Upper Week Monday, being 28th. So take advantage of that. That will be the last for this quarter. Take advantage. The forms are available. Go to the office and pick up those forms, and God will honor you in the name of Jesus Christ. Rise up on your feet. Rise up on your feet. Our Father is on official assignment. He'll be with us from tomorrow. Rise up on your feet. Lift up your voice and appreciate God for this service. Lord, we give you thanks. We exalt. We honor you. We give you all the glory. We give you all the honor for your faithfulness, for your kindness, for your love. Be thou exalted, Jesus. For in Jesus' mighty name we pray. We thank you for the faith without. Thank you for the multitude you brought. Thank you for the first timers. Thank you for the souls. To you alone be all the glory. For in Jesus' mighty name we pray. On behalf of God's servant, our Father, we declare you blessed. In the name of Jesus Christ, 2022 shall be a walkover for you and your family. Every seed of the wicked over your marriage, over your career, over your health, over your business, over your faith, over your finance is hereby destroyed in the name of Jesus Christ. A mark of exemption is placed upon you now. A mark of exemption is placed upon you now. The same way they sent for Joseph, they will send for you this week. I say this year shall be your year of laughter. What have taken others years to achieve, this year you are achieving it. I say this year you are achieving it. The louder your amen, the faster your testimony. For in Jesus' mighty name we pray. Surely God's goodness and mercy shall follow us all the days of our lives. And we shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever and ever. Amen. Praise the Lord, I'm more than a conqueror. Congratulations. Amen and amen. Please, this is a way of exit. The door open there is a way of exit so that others can come in through this direction. Just take this way to exit. If you are for second service, go on and sit down. In case you came after the offering I've been taking, there's a late offering basket here. Endeavor to come and drop your late offering. Those offerings are declared blessed in Jesus' name.
Praise the Lord, I'm more than a conqueror. We are here for the second service. Shall we rise up on our feet and begin to appreciate God this beautiful Sunday? Give him all the praise. Give him all the praise. The second service is about to start. Please, if you are here for the second service, begin to come in. Rise up on our feet and begin to give him praise this morning. Lord, we thank you for another wonderful Sunday. We give you praise and anointing Sunday, our covenant day of exemption. Father, I give you praise this morning. Is somebody praying? Is somebody praying? Give him all the glory for another wonderful Sunday. Lord, we give you praise. The psalmist